Tonight, we are celebrating quite the honor for a local woman. She is among the four newest members of the advisory council of a new museum that will honor American women's history. It'll be located on the National Mall in our nation's capital. Now, our Maki Becker traveled down to Salamanca, and she met with this trailblazing woman at a museum right here in our region to talk about how history there will influence her work in Washington, D.C.
I'm here at the Seneca Iroquois National Museum, where I'm meeting with Odie Brant Porter to talk to her about her exciting new position with the Smithsonian Institute.
Why is women's history written in invisible ink? Right?
Yeah.
And why is that?
It's a question that a new Smithsonian Museum in our nation's capital is hoping to answer. And Odie Porter, a Seneca Nation counselor, will quite literally have a seat at the table. Porter was just appointed to the advisory board for the Smithsonian American Women's History Museum. She's the only indigenous woman on the board.
I'm a Turtle clan. I'm also a mother of four children. My husband's Robert Odawi Porter, and I grew up here on the Allegheny Territory in these beautiful rolling hills.
Porter showed me around the Seneca Iroquois National Museum in Salamanca.
Everything was our Aboriginal territory, which you're aware of.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is great.
She told me how she wants the new museum to reflect the role indigenous women played in the suffragette movement.
Iroquois women, Haudenosaunee women, were working side by side with a lot of these colonial women. And you would even see the dress. We had freedom of dress. We owned our own land. We were not the property of men. We had control over the children. That's an interesting story that I think I'd like to explore that more.
The museum is still in the planning stages, at least 8 years from opening, though they have identified space on the National Mall where they'd like it to be. In the meantime, you can check out a digital exhibit on the museum's website. You'll find a link with this story at wkbw.com.
I envision that you're going to walk away with thinking that indigenous women had a pretty significant impact on the formation of this country.
Maki Becker, 7 News, Salamanca.